Calangaman Island is one of the most famous tourist attractions in Leyte Island and is listed as the most beautiful island in the province and even the Philippines. The long dusty white sandbars at both ends of the island are one of its distinguishing features. Its calm and transparent waters make it ideal for swimming and diving. There are no private resorts or accommodations on the island, but kampong is allowed. This is a paradise and dream weekend getaway on Leyte Island. Most people come here just to enjoy the beautiful beaches, impressive sandbars and incredible views. Calangaman Island is located in Palampon, Leyte. Canigao Island is one of the most famous tourist attractions on Leyte Island. This is an uninhabited island, surrounded by white sandy beaches and turquoise waters, and its center is full of trees. You can walk on the island for about 20 minutes. The best part is that it is very cheap to get here, you only need to pay about 40 pesos for the entrance fee and 60 pesos for the boat fare. If you plan to stay overnight, you can rent a country house or pitch a tent. It is also an ideal destination for swimming and snorkeling on Leyte Island, as it is full of coral reefs and marine life. Canigao Island is 20 minutes far from the port of Matalong, Leyte. Digio Island is one of Leyte's most visited tourist attractions and is part of the four small island groups called Four Islands. The other islands are called Mahaba, Apid and Shemokiran. Digio Island is the smallest of the four islands, but it is called the most beautiful island. It has a long sandbar and is the main attraction on the island. The clear water is perfect for swimming. There are small wooden houses on the island, but you can also set up your own tent, and seafood is also fine. This is the first stop for everyone who wants a day trip, but most tourists tend to spend the night here and explore the remaining islands in the first few days. Digio Island is located in Cuatro Islas, Inupakan, Leyte. Marhaba Island, as the name suggests, has a slender shape and is one of the beautiful islands among the four islands. This is an island covered with dense vegetation and beautiful white sand beaches and clear waters. Most of the time, there is a famous sandbar parallel to the beach on the east side of the island. When the sun gets too hot, it still has beautiful rock formations and shades. If you want to snorkel, please let your boatman stop for a while where corals and marine life abound. Mahaba Island is located in Cuatro Islas, Inupakan, Leyte. Apid Island is also one of Leyte's most famous tourist attractions and one of the beautiful islands that make up the four islands. It is the second largest island in the archipelago. It has a small town where most people live by fishing and harvesting shellfish. It also has a long white sand beach and clear water for swimming. Apid Island enjoys beautiful views of the Camote Sea, with some mangroves growing along the coast. Apid Island is located in Cuatro Islas, Inupakan, Leyte. Himokilan Island is the largest island in the archipelago. It also has white sandy beaches and crystal clear waters, which invites you to do so. The island is covered by trees and rock formations, and there is a small town near the beach. On the way to the island, you can see a lot of corals. Some parts of the island do not allow swimming, snorkeling, diving or fishing because it is considered a marine reserve. Most tourists who don't have much time on day trips tend to circle the island and witness its normal beauty instead of stopping at the beach. Himokilan Island is located in Cuatro Islas, Kindang, Leyte. Danau Lake is one of the recommended lake destinations in the Philippines in Leyte. This is a guitar-shaped lake with an area of 148 hectares and an elevation of 2,130 feet, which means that the temperature in Tagaytay is almost the same. This is a quiet and relaxing place. The best thing to do here is to have lunch with family or loved ones on a floating raft on the lake. Swimming, kayaking and canoeing are also fun activities. There is also a viewing platform from above, you can see the beautiful scenery of the whole lake surrounded by mountains. Lake Danau is 18 kilometers distance from Ormoc City, Leyte. The San Juanico Bridge is one of the most famous tourist attractions on Leyte Island and the longest bridge across the sea in the Philippines. This is a $21.9 million bridge. It was a gift from Ferdinand Marcos, the 10th president of the Philippines, to his wife Imelda Marcos. It took 4 years to build. The bridge connects the provinces of Samar and Leyte, with a total length of 2.16 kilometers. You can see beautiful views of sunrise and sunset, incredible panoramic views of the sea and islands, small whirlpools and passing ships. In the early morning or afternoon, this is a favorite destination for runners, photographers and nature lovers, romantic couples. San Juanico Bridge can be accessed in Tacloban City, Leyte. One of Wright's most famous tourist attractions is Santo Niño Shrine and Heritage Museum, one of the 29 presidential lounges built by the Marcos family, is almost entirely dedicated to his wife Imelda Marcos. A small church dedicated to Santo Niño is the one who rules the bottom. It has 13 rooms with different themes and gorgeous designs and decorations. The banquet hall, meeting room and bedroom of the first family are located on the second floor. The interior of the museum is full of expensive or priceless paintings, ancient ceramics, pottery, three-dimensional models, religious artifacts and sculptures. This is Wright's recommended destination and you must witness a part of its history. Santo Niño Shrine and Heritage Museum is located in Tacloban City, Leyte. The MacArthur Landing Memorial National Park is to commemorate the fulfillment of General MacArthur's "I will come back" promise at Wright Red Beach. The focal point of the park is the 7 life-size double bronze statues of MacArthur and his entourage, including former President Sergio Osmeña, the 3rd President of the Philippines, by the sculptor Anastasia Cado, is based on the iconic photo of Gatano Fail Lakes. This was the historical landing site of General MacArthur and marked the beginning of the movement to liberate the Philippines from the Japanese occupation, which led to the largest naval battle in World War II that took place 3 years before the defeat of Japan. MacArthur Landing Memorial National Park is located in Palo, Leyte.
We hope you liked the video we shared with you. We need your support to share it with people who want to visit the beautiful places here in the Philippines. Please don't forget to like, share and subscribe to our YouTube and Facebook channel. Hit that notification bell to receive newly uploaded video. Keep safe and have a good day.